Thank you for joining today's session on how to create out-of-the-box assessments and monitor your progress with Compliance Manager. As we've all observed, the number of regulations that companies are subject to is increasing, as is the complexity of these regulations and the frequency with which they're updated. Many organizations collect consumer or user data, and there's an increasing need to protect that data. For example, following the enforcement of GDPR in 2018, many regions have enacted their own data protection regulations, several of which have gone into effect this year, including California's Consumer Privacy Act in July, Thailand's PDPA in May, and Brazil's LGPD in August. Accordingly, it has become increasingly difficult to stay up to date with the volume and frequency of new regulations and regulatory updates. We developed Compliance Manager to help you with this issue and are here today to show you how to assess, monitor, and improve your compliance posture using our solution. Now, I'll walk you through how you can make the best use of our library of over 150 out-of-the-box assessments, explain how you can make the most of their built-in control mapping, and provide some additional detail on the logic that goes into our powerful compliance score reporting capability. Here we are on the Compliance Manager homepage, where you can quickly assess your compliance posture by taking a look at your compliance score. Once configured, this score will illustrate your progress against the set of regulations and standards that you have chosen based on their relevance to your organization. Your compliance score consists of points, which you achieve by taking recommended actions to improve your compliance. You are also given points based on the actions that Microsoft has taken on your behalf as your cloud service provider. To make your compliance score relevant to your organization, you'll first want to set up assessments which represent the regulations that your company is subject to. To get started, let's jump straight into the Assessments tab. Here, you'll find a list of all of the assessments that have been set up in your tenant already. By pulling from these assessments, Compliance Manager provides specific and actionable compliance recommendations and shows you details regarding your compliance against the controls supporting these regulations. By default, you'll have the data protection baseline set up already, which provides a set of recommendations for how you can protect your data. The data protection baseline derives these recommendations from best practices for compliance across NIST, ISO, and GDPR frameworks. If you would like to quickly add additional assessments, you can do so by leveraging the Add Assessment button located on this tab. Alternately, if you prefer to take a closer look at the full library of assessment templates available to you, including digging in to the specific recommendations, actions, and control mappings, you can hop into the Assessment Template tab. Either way, you'll be able to leverage our expansive library of assessment templates, which cover major regulations and standards, as well as those pertaining to regional and industry-specific requirements. And in case we don't have what you're looking for, or you'd like to perform additional customization, you can modify assessment templates to meet any unique compliance needs you may have. Let's head to the Assessment Template tab to take a look at our options for assessment creation. Here, we can view our library of out-of-the-box assessment templates and dive into any specific templates of interest. For now, let's start working on NIST 853. We can click into this assessment template to take a closer look. Each out-of-the-box template maps to a specific regulation or framework, in this case, NIST 853, and contains all of that regulation or framework's control families and controls built directly from the text of the framework. On top of that, we provide details on the actions that Microsoft has already taken to meet any relevant controls, as well as recommended actions that users such as yourself can implement to help address the remaining controls. As I mentioned, we are creating an assessment of this template to start the work of assessing ourselves against the NIST 853 regulation. If I wanted additional information on the included controls and actions, I could use the Controls, Improvement Actions, and Microsoft Actions tabs to perform a deep dive or export the whole template to Excel. For now, though, we'll go ahead and click the Create Assessment button In order to bring the NIST 853 assessment into our tenant and start assessing ourselves against the regulation. Now, we can name our assessment as well as select a group. Groups help you manage your work on assessments in accordance with your organization's compliance processes. For example, if you'd like to delineate your compliance projects by audit year, subsidiary, or regional business unit, you can create representative groups and add assessments to each to separate the work. Once we add the assessment to the appropriate group, we can click Next, then review our choices and confirm by hitting Create Assessment, then Done, at which point we're redirected to our newly created assessment. It looks like we've already made some progress on this assessment. Microsoft's actions are contributing all of our current points, but Compliance Manager will also begin to scan our current M365 configuration and indicate when we complete recommended actions. If we want to extend beyond the Microsoft 365 product boundary, you can create a custom assessment to assess the compliance of non-M365 products. In fact, you can tune in to our other skilling session, which addresses exactly that. We can also click into the Controls tab to take a closer look at exactly how all these actions relate to the specific controls within NIST 853. Each assessment that we ship contains the mapping details of how the regulation or framework's controls relate to the actions we recommend, allowing you to see exactly how the work you're doing helps satisfy various control requirements. Here, we can see our progress within each control area and drill down into specific controls. Clicking directly into a specific control allows us to see recommended improvement actions for this control, as well as relevant actions already taken by Microsoft. Thanks to our control mapping framework, the actions that we recommend you take can be relevant to multiple controls within other assessments, removing the need for duplicative work. For example, turning on multi-factor authentication helps address controls from nearly 50 different regulations. As you take these recommended actions and address controls, you can export a report to demonstrate the work that you've done. This report will include all of the relevant status and documentation areas, including any notes that you've taken, showing you a complete picture of all of the work that you and Microsoft have completed. In addition to reporting, you can always refer back to your compliance score to see how the actions you have taken have impacted your overall progress. Your compliance score is a quantifiable measure of your compliance posture across all of your assessments and groups, and each action you take has a different impact on your score, depending on the potential risks you're helping to mitigate. As a result, the points assigned to each action can help prioritize where to direct your compliance efforts to maximize the impact on your overall compliance posture. Efficiency in achieving compliance and prioritizing actions to meet multiple regulations and standards is a must-have, but is often challenging. We hope that this session today has helped you understand how to leverage Compliance Manager's over 150 out-of-the-box assessment templates. To learn more about customizing these assessments to meet your business's unique compliance requirements, tune in to our sessions about extending and customizing assessments in Compliance Manager. Thank you for listening and have a great day.